Here we are. We're on here now.
We're rolling.
Where are we? We're here at the Christmas house in Torrington.
Yes, sir.
What's the deal with the Christmas house? What do we have going on here?
Christmas house has been around for a very long time. Good 30 plus years. And I don't know about you, Dave, but when I think about the holiday season, there's no other place I think about than the Christmas house here in the heart of downtown Torrington, Connecticut.
I've heard so much about it. Oh man, there's a lot of like really, really loud trucks right now.
Yeah,
it's a little loud out here right now.
Intersection. No
doubt. So I've heard so much about this house, but I've never actually been here. It's actually kind of something interesting going on right now, right?
Absolutely. So unfortunately, the Christmas house might not last a minute longer beyond the season because the owner, Ron, recently had this house.
Why don't we go in the driveway so we can maybe hear a little better?
let's show off a little bit of this.
All right, go.
So our viewers can know what we're talking about here and why they should come out here after 6 o'clock at night.
Yeah, obviously, so they have, you know, we're doing this during the day, but it is a better attraction at night. And they've got a GoFundMe page set up here, which is something that Greg's gonna talk to us about in a minute. Look at that.
But Ron uses over 300,000 lights here to light up this spectacle. You can probably see from outer space rather easily, just a big giant ball of light, more or less. It's a very fascinating place because it's definitely one man's passion to just share his joy of Christmas with not just Torrington or the county, but the greater state of Connecticut, more or less.
Yeah, you actually do see this on a lot of like Christmas attractions in Connecticut.
Absolutely. So if it's not Christmas Village, which is where we aired from last time while the two of us were here in Torrington,
which might actually be like 1 year ago today,
it could very well be. Yeah. Then if it's not that, which is literally just a quarter mile up the street from here, then you got this beloved Christmas house.
All right, so now that we're getting to a place where we can hear a little more, what's going on with the Christmas house?
So unfortunately, like I was alluding to before, the Christmas house might not last beyond the season because the house recently foreclosed. So Ron's got himself a GoFundMe thing going on, and he's looking to try to get $35,000. And I do have the link.
Is that what he could get that to buy this house
to
back?
To buy it back from the bank.
Okay.
Absolutely. So, you know, they fell on hard times. They haven't been able to pay any bills for a while and whatnot. But, you know, it's sad because, I mean, this man's electric bill alone, when he's got this thing up and going, is a good solid $1,000 by itself per month. Electricity.
Wow.
I mean, you can look up there. You see all these different bulbs and whatnot.
I've never been in the Christmas house, so now I'm thinking, like, I'm definitely going to have to come back here.
Oh, yeah. You could definitely go. Once it's open, which it's not right now because we're here rather early, you could go up the stairs through the door, and you make your way up this, like, little narrow staircase, and he usually has, like, hot cocoa and candy canes up at the top of the stairs for yourself to indulge in.
So he only needs to raise $35,000 and then he can keep the house and potentially do this next year too?
You say only, but
I know.
He might be a little hard pressed to get that money. I hope he does. I hope everyone visits his GoFundMe and chips in a few bucks.
Maybe the millions of people that are going to watch this video
It's worth coming out to. I mean, there's one other person I know that kind of comes close, but he's out in South Windsor and he doesn't do a good enough job like this guy does. I mean, look at it. It's like the Michael Jackson of Christmas houses.
There was the one in New Britain, which I don't think is happening anymore.
Okay.
But yeah, this is one that
It doesn't just stop here. I mean, you're looking at all this, but it also goes into his backyard.
You think maybe we could take a peek?
Yeah, we could probably take a peek.
Let's do it.
I mean, house is pretty much always
so actually, you know, like,
domain forever.
Like, being in real estate, I do find it interesting what's going on here, actually.
Absolutely.
So,
I hope that if Ron were to leave, whoever wants to take over this property in the future would want to continue the tradition of keeping it as the Christmas house.
So that's true. That would be the another option, is that, you know, if it doesn't work out, all these decorations are...
you got to wonder where they
would go. Yeah, he probably keeps them somewhere, and they could be put up again next year. And
I mean, you got Big Bird back there.
Somebody who does this much work obviously has a plan that they incorporate every year, and we're not even seeing what's inside right now.
No. Okay. Maybe we could come back for a part two.
I think, actually, we should probably work that out.
What do the viewers have to say? Are they in support of that? That we
yeah,
come back
let,
at
let us
night
know
sometime?
If you think that Greg and I should come back here at night when the house is actually open. I'm pretty sure that's going to be a unanimous yes, but, you know.
When it's all lit up, you won't see our faces. You'll just see tons of crazy blue and red and green lights.
So, that's pretty much the story. You got to save the Christmas house.
Yeah, and... If you live in some place like West Hartford or Hartford or Southington, you know, take the 40, 45 minutes drive out here to Main Street, Torrington. There's a beautiful tattoo shop across the street and a Boost Mobile.
Yep. So I'm thinking sometime next week
we'll come back here at when it's dark out. So like after 6, we'll get back to you with the details. In the meantime, if you want to
help out, what is it? What is the guy's name here?
It's Ron Merriman.
Ron Merriman.
And his direct GoFundMe page is gofundme.com/GP33. There's also a link on my Facebook page. It's right at the top.
All right. And down here are the hours. Oh, there you go. That's his name, Merriman Christmas House. This is very well done. I can't wait to see what's back there. This is something, I mean, now I'm realizing I pretty much have to do it.
So, beautiful.
That's it. It's not just like a normal looking road here in downtown Torrington. All right. So watch out. We'll be back here when it's dark out sometime in the next week.
T-town, baby.
All right. We're live.
Hey, hey.
Oh, there you go. Oh, there we are. Right here.
There's you.
We're back here for part two at the Christmas house. And let's just remind everybody what's going on here.
So,
where are we?
We're in Torrington, Connecticut.
Yep.
Right in the heart on Main Street.
Speak up, of course. Yep.
Yeah. It's basically downtown Torrington. Not the nicest place on earth, but no place I'd rather be when it comes to thinking about Christmas and the holidays. Why? Because standing, well, right behind us across the street, well, show them, Dave. This is what I'm talking about.
We're going to go over there in a minute, but, like, check this place out. So,
last time we were here, it was...
it was daytime.
It was before 4 o'clock. The sun was still up. No lights were shining bright. And there was a notice that said that they don't turn the lights on until 6 o'clock, and we weren't going to twiddle our thumbs doing nothing for two hours.
So we're back.
Yeah, we made an effort to want to do a sequel and do the Christmas house some justice.
We're going in tonight.
And as you can see, there's a lot of people flocking to the almighty Christmas house.
Oh, we should brief everybody on the controversy that's going on here too, of course.
Yeah, so the house has been placed in recent foreclosure. The bank owns it. Ron, who did own the house, has failed to make a mortgage payment. He's fallen on hard times. And, you know, he and the good people of Torrington are in dire need of trying to save this legendary place that's been around for close to 30 years. I mean, he's been doing this tradition for as long as I can remember. And even back in the day when he was younger, he used to do decorations for
like St. Patrick's Day and have like giant four-leaf clovers.
So he's not just a Christmas guy. He's
no.
like he's just festive
and
in general.
Valentine's right. Day and Halloween.
So but, the long and short Christmas is like, we could like talk about that nonstop. But basically the deal is, in order to keep his house,
he needs your help.
He needs $35,000. And I believe he still needs all of that $35,000.
Yeah, since part one was made, you guys have helped contribute $0.
But neither has anyone else.
He's got a whopping $200.
All right, are we ready? Are we ready to go in? Maybe show this place off a little bit.
Let's do it. We're gonna do some jaywalking now.
Oh, don't call the cops on us.
No crackheads will hit us.
All right, so we're gonna turn around here. We're gonna take it out here.
Greg can keep starring in it. Tell us what's going on here.
So he's got his nice handwritten sign here that says please donate, and he's got the address gofundme.com/gp33.
All right, we can
so he can reach his goal of $25,000.
All right,
I forget how many lights he uses. I think it's around 300,000 electric bills. Thing going from 6 to I think 10:30 at night.
So how much per night?
Well, I don't know.
Probably depends on
you. Do the math.
It's a lot.
Yeah.
But we're gonna go in. We're gonna go inside.
Yeah.
Right?
You don't have to go to Disney World to see something.
This is very Disney World like. I'm glad that we got to come out here tonight because earlier today we were having basically a hurricane.
Oh,
and we thought maybe we wouldn't get to do this.
It's a lovely night out. I mean, it's still, you know, 55 degrees. And I almost went down with just a t-shirt, but yeah. It started to cool off a little bit, so I had to put a sweater on.
All right, so what
on.
Do we do next? How does this work?
We make
I haven't been here before, so.
So we got to go inside, and then we have to see the backyard. Which would you rather do first? Would you rather see the back? Or?
When you've been here before, what so has been?
Let's go up the stairs.
All right, cool. It's like an episode of Cribs. Christmas Cribs. So going through this like archway thing, we got some.
Got Mrs. Claus Santa here. Claus
and, yeah, cool. All right.
Santa's sleeping here.
Okay.
Oh, there he is.
That's like
this. Oh, that's Mrs. Claus snoring there.
That's cool.
Oh yeah. A lot of animatronics going on.
Yeah, this is pretty impressive.
This guy has devoted his entire life
and look at this
passion to just delivering Christmas at its finest. We got some carolers over here.
Yeah, we got Santa
and his elves.
And some elves. There's Mrs. Claus.
Yep. And Frosty's here too.
Wow. That's pretty awesome. Okay.
So there's no cell phone talking.
No phone's talking. I'm not talking on my cell phone.
No. We can just
take in photos.
Videotape, and anyone that's watching right now can just take it all in.
Yep. All right, right here we got a dancing Santa.
This is going to be the best Christmas ever. Up where the housetop reindeer paws out
just for the
old Santa Claus. Down through the chimney with lots of...
Oh, man. Look at this. Who left their Dunkin' here?
Oh, man. That's not cool. That's not nice. Oh, look at these. We got an elf wearing sunglasses here. All right, we going in?
We're going in.
All right, let's do this.
It's a little tight.
I'm so excited.
Alright, so we got nutcrackers.
Man, I couldn't fit another Dear Santa letter if I tried.
It's like a mailbox for letters to Santa. Sensory overload. Wow.
All right. Look at the Coca-Cola display.
player.
I would say he has to leave this stuff set up all year. Yeah.
You would think. Oh, I have one of these things at home. But it kind of like stands like a glow.
Just in case anybody is wondering, it smells kind of like a dive bar in here.
Yeah, you'd be chain smoking too if you were losing your house.
Alright, so it says we can't go in here, but room here. Oh, there's the Grinch. Alright, so that back there must be like where he actually lives. Alright.
Evil Dom.
This is an extensive collection of nutcrackers over here.
That's a little tight.
More creepy killers.
This is like the coolest case of hoarding I think I've ever seen.
Yeah, I think this is a fire hazard.
Possibly. It's a Connecticut treasure, though. Alright, so we're going up to the third floor now.
Come on. Alright. Hey, would you like to interview Ron?
If he wants to be.
Hey, would you like to do an interview with us?
My taco. Where's my tacos?
Buffalo. Western New York.
We got some people checking out the display with us on Facebook here.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, I'm all over that, man. I'm trying to get the city of Torrington pissed off at me. I went out here the other night.
Yeah.
Till 2 o'clock in the morning. There's so many pages of this house on there, man. And you have Christmas Village on it. You punch it up, and my house pops up all over that. So that's what the big conflict in this town is.
Well, yeah, I mean, you know, Torrington won't be the same without having Christmas Village and the Christmas House.
We're
gonna
be
going hand in hand.
We got a battle in the courts. They're trying to fix me first of January, but it ain't gonna happen. We're gonna be back in court.
So you're thinking we'll be back here again next year?
I'm gonna be here. Yeah. I don't give a shit.
All right.
I got a lot of people behind me want to push this thing. You know.
We will definitely stand behind you.
I owe $4,000 on the house. That's all I owe. $22,000.
Well, we're sharing the GoFundMe with everybody, you know.
We're getting the word out.
We're doing as best we can.
The one in Torrington's not moving. It stayed at 200 for the last 3 months. It's not going nowhere.
You have another one?
There's one in Torrington here set up. We sent one up. But the girl was set up, I think, screwed it all up. Because people are having a tough time trying to identify where it's at. You know, they shouldn't know.
Right.
Do you know how much is on those other GoFundMes?
I don't know. I meant to check them before I came tonight, but I haven't seen it.
Because I can't get in. I don't even know where they are.
We'll definitely be checking it later.
The only one that I've seen was the one that you have on the sign up front.
Yeah, that's screwed up.
It said GP33.
Yeah, something screwed up.
Okay.
It's not working right. I don't know what it is. Everybody keeps telling me to put into it, but it still says it's $200. I don't understand what the hell's going on.
Yeah, I noticed that. I'm like, because we're getting the word out, and I'm surprised.
Yeah.
No one's touched it.
Wow, thanks a lot, man.
Several weeks.
What I'm going to do, if we save it, I'm going to open the second floor up next year. I'm not going down to the first. My sister's going out of here. Downstairs, I'll pull everything out of storage, start setting up that downstairs.
Cool. We need more publicity, though. That's what I'm thinking.
Another village.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I got a... See, the thing is, Webster's paying games. I got a letter from their lawyers from Farmington for $11,600, right, for paying off on the mortgage. Then the Webster Bank sends me a letter for $8,000. So what's going on here? Then they had an auction out here. Nobody bidded on it. So they decided to throw $22,000 on it, try to block me on it.
Really?
Yeah, this is the shit they're pulling. Mm. They can't do that. Girl told me up here that against the law to do that. She said they're going to get their ass on me jammed for that. That's how my American bank got screwed down there pulling that shit on people down. They got a $1 billion lawsuit on their ass. So they're getting a lot of flack. I know that because they sent me a letter already. They want to do some negotiation or shit down there. Right? You have federal rights. So that's why you're going to shoot in front of me before. Why are you waiting it out now?
Yeah.
They're getting heated up. That's definitely that. So, I got a couple guys out down south that are, they started some GoFundMes down there too. They got a couple of them going too. I had a couple guys from Boston came in. My buddy flew in from Florida. He wants to drop me $10,000 on it. He says, I'll get the taxes out of the way. You know, and about $14,000 is all we owe on between taxes and house.
There you go.
But I'm not dropping this house for about $4,000 in the Webster Bank.
No.
$20,000 on it, it's all been paid off, and I'm going to hand it for $4,000.
you could give them the finger by reprising some of the old classics you had with like the old St. Patty's Day theme and Valentine's Day.
And, that's what he was just telling me. You do a bunch of other holidays and
I
not
do Valentine's,
just Christmas, right?
St. Patrick's, Memorial Day. We had a 250th anniversary here one year. I built a 12-foot layer cake out here. You know the chaser lights they have for Christmas, like these up here?
Yeah.
I put 250 of those on a cake with PVC pipe all cut. They're all canned, the whole cake. And I added 250 of water on it and turned on top.
You did Halloween, too.
I stopped at the two gasoline on my archway. The kid in the back house over here didn't almost set the whole house on fire over here.
Wow.
I stopped doing it, yeah. I caught him. He came to the door, the cops knocked on the door. It smelled like gas, so I nailed him. I thought dummy was.
So this is just like a hobby for you.
Yeah,
passion,
I used to do business.
Know?
I used to do a lot of business decorating. Toy Colony Restaurant, I used to do the whole inside of that place up and stuff. But they don't pay nothing out. It's not worth it. I used to do all these buildings down through here free of charge. You couldn't even light them up, so I stopped doing it. Anthony's the only one I got left on right now. You can't get any motivated in this town. You have 30-some empty stores downtown.
Yeah.
There's no reason for that to be empty like that. You're a town that houses Christmas Village. Promote it, you assholes. You're a Christmas town, stupids.
Yeah.
It's right there.
Yeah.
Just use it. They don't get it. They just
It's got a permanent Christmas Village. Yeah.
We bought 38 snowflakes down at Center Bridge. Those big snowflakes, the presidential flakes. We bought those. Cost $30,000. They haven't been put up in 3 years. They only put six of them up. The rest have been sitting in a warehouse for 3 years. I just think, Carbone, where's the snowflake? Oh, we're going to sell them. No, you're not going to sell them. We were Ryan Bingham when he was in office. And we worked our ass to get those. I said, you're not going to sell them. Where's the brackets stolen? I said, oh, I don't know. They must have thrown them away. Those brackets are $45 a piece. I said, I have for those.
I forget exactly how many years have you been doing this now for?
This has been open 16 in here, outside 37 years.
37 for the outside, 16 for the inside.
Okay, yeah, that's cool. That's my entire life.
Yep.
Yeah. 37
awesome.
Years.
I started in 1982 outside.
Okay, yeah, that's when I was born.
Yeah, I was born in January 81.
All right. Well, we better keep going. Ron, check it out. Thank you for showing us your house. Yep. Yep. All right, here we go. Next part.
Did we get all that on tape?
Oh, okay. So if you couldn't figure that out, that's like the owner of this house. He's trying to keep his house. And hopefully we helped him.
Whoa, whoa, bubbles. Bubbles coming from the ceiling. I don't know if you want to eat those.
I don't know how many dolls there are here. No, you don't want to touch that. Not with your tongue, anyways.
Wow, look at this. No, this is so cool.
He loves his Coca-Cola, too, that's for sure.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, look at this. I mean, this is like one of the most extensive collections of this kind of stuff I've like ever seen.
So, Dave, don't you have a question for the people right now? Like, what are you doing still watching this video? You should be making your way down to downtown Torrington right now.
Yeah.
And feasting your eyes in person.
Yeah, come check it out in person.
Look at the depth. That's
what is the address here again?
It's 285 Main Street.
285 Main Street, Torrington, Connecticut. This is the Christmas house.
It's free to get in, but of course,
it is free. Maybe it shouldn't be, though, because he's about to lose his house.
I would pay $20.
Maybe he's not. I don't know. We're going to figure it out.
I will leave a donation on the way out.
I think I will, too.
Yes.
All right.
Look at all these dolls.
I just don't ever remember it going this deep because
I was here with Allison a couple years ago.
Yeah.
And it only stopped right on the second floor. We're up on we're on the
Let's keep going. Let's keep going. Let's go down. Alright. I would imagine he'd be pretty good at Halloween too. But it sounds
this is how you get out.
Yeah, let's go. Alright. Going down.
First, I'm going to show my generosity.
Ah, donation. Maybe I'll put something in that box to myself.
Because Torrington needs to keep this going.
Mm-hmm. All right. It's a Connecticut treasure.
It's the heart and soul of Christmas right here in the middle of Litchfield County.
World famous Litchfield County, Connecticut. Alright, we're going down. And there's just stuff everywhere. It's just there's endless supply.
Christmas and Coca-Cola.
Coca-Cola has had a lot of Christmas stuff over the years too.
With their polar bears.
Polar bears.
Wow, just look at that.
Wow. All right. I'm glad we came back. This is very cool to see.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, these are like all kinds of awards he has on the wall of, you know, his past displays.
Let's see where some people have come from to visit. We got someone from Palm Springs, California. And I don't know where
some town called Wincest.
Yeah, who would do that?
I don't know. I've never heard of that town.
So from West Hartford. I'll hold this for you.
Yep. Well, put Dave.
Are you signed?
Dave. I'm going to write my full last name and my address is Don't Worry About It.
Oh, okay.
All right. There we go.
All right. We keep going.
Down another set of stairs before we go outside again.
Yeah.
And then there's a whole backyard to explore.
It's really great that we got that guy in the video.
We got Ron on tape. Yeah, I have not seen that guy in many, many years.
He is just hanging out tonight. So we got a big bird right here. And actually, when we were here during the day, we could tell what this actually is. It's a fenced-in backyard with an above-ground pool.
I don't know if you ever open it up to make it like a maze to go through. I think you could just look from the outside and not actually go in there.
I could be wrong.
You remember going in there like a maid?
No, I don't think you could. Or never could. No.
If it were me though, I'd turn it into a haunted Christmas maze. Where like scary looking elves would pop out of the woodwork and scream at you. That's just me. And
I think that's basically it.
All right.
Oh, that's the Torrington Fire Department at work, I hear, in the background.
But actually, before we go, we should go back out front once more. So let's head back out there and show them the GoFundMe again.
If you're flying in a little Cessna right now, you'll see this giant.
You would
ball
see it.
Light.
This is like the most extensive Christmas decoration house I've ever seen, really.
Absolutely.
I've heard about it for years, never came until this year, and when I came before with Greg, I was like, we got to come back at night. And the idea that it might not come back next year, that's kind of too bad. So I do hope...
Ron's going to fight tooth and nail, but
it
he's
sounds
got a long
like
battle
it.
Ahead of him.
It sounds like it. So let's go check out the GoFundMe address one more time. What do we got here? It says, please donate GoFundMe.com/GP33. Please help save the Christmas house.
It says that there's only $200 donated there. He said it's a little messed up, but that's not accurate at all.
And he seems to have a...
I take it back, viewers. We know you've been helping all along.
He has an inspiring conviction that he will not lose his house. And his name is Ron, right?
Ron.
Yeah, look at this.
Ron Merriman. It's the Merriman Christmas House.
Merriman Christmas House.
Open from 6 to 11 on the outside, and you can visit between the hours of 6 and 9 o'clock.
Probably open for at least a couple more days, right?
Yeah, they'll be open on Christmas Eve because I've been here on Christmas Eve and maybe Christmas Day too.
All right.
So you still have a couple more days, folks. And watch out, don't step behind you.
Oh, yep.
There's live traffic here.
Yeah, so let's just pan over one more time. Check out the Christmas house on Main Street in Torrington. It's really quite impressive. Let's see if we can keep it going.
He used to give out hot chocolate and candy canes and stuff like that, but you know his budget's tight.
Yeah,
it's real tight.
All right, so he's
not giving anything out other than a cheer through the music and the lights.
So let's There we go. All right, I guess that's pretty much it for the Christmas house.
So, we'll see.
Any parting words? Yeah. Come on down to Torrington. Check out the Christmas house.